It was just the beginning. It was a very dark ass record. I remember when we did the 20th anniversary, I remember us playing it, and I'm coming off stage just like depressed. Fucking, we live in all that shit. It's just like, damn, this is a dark record. But playing it in its entirety, it was like, damn. Yeah, I was in a very dark place. All of us were. I was some little kid from Bakersfield that got picked on the whole album. I'm like, what? And some of us were just born different. And in this town, you're eating up if you're different. This is more like machismo, farmer, oil field type people. I was bullied, alienated, being called a faggot my whole life. I guess I was just different, and I was frail and small and skinny, and I had horrible health issues because I had asthma at that time. It wasn't really bad until high school. Got into high school, I'm getting my ass kicked in the hallways. I mean, at that time it was accepted that's what you had to go through, but it was just a tough time for me. Like, I've been beat on so much that I'm talking to those people that were so insecure they had to pick on me. What are the lies that you had to say to make you so fucking cool? It's me talking, like, do you ever sit outside your fears talking about your life, thinking about your inner fears? Like, I did that when I got drunk, and as my band started to hate me, is one of the reasons why I got sober, is when I'd get on the bus, the whole band would either go in their bunk or leave the bus, because when I was drunk, I wasn't violent, but I was mentally mean. You know what your problem is, monkey? You know what your problem is, Fieldy? And I would go there mentally, and that's that kind of that vibe of the song, talking to those people that were mean to me. Part of growing up, unfortunately, but constantly being called out, even by teachers, or them laughing at me in class because someone called me a faggot. Really fucks with your head. It makes you so angry. You know, high school is supposed to be the best time of your life. I mean, that's what you're made to believe. When that came out and people just started telling me stories, I was so young. You know, I got bullied, I was called a faggot, everything. That started to make me feel really overwhelmed. I was like, holy shit, what is all this? And like, put me up on this pedestal. Oh, here we go. Oh my God, this is crazy. It was weird. In the beginning, I think I was this crazy tweaker. I had to weigh like 120 pounds. Was just in this crazy green jumpsuit, flipping out. I actually wore makeup back then. I was kind of like in drag without wearing a dress or anything. But it just was like over the top. I was so lost, depressed, scared of the world, heavily using meth and alcohol, whatever I could get my hands on. It was just a wild, weird time in my life. Just turned 17 when I started doing autopsies at the coroner's office. I loved all the horror films, and I loved the gory ones, so I'm like, man, this is gotta be cool to be actually a sick little ass, cut up dead bodies and see what's inside of my mind. It was coming from a dark place, I guess, and it just, reality just punched me in the face. First time I saw a dead body, I'm like, this could be me anytime. I was working on kids my age. I was working on kids younger than me. I was working on babies. It just was later in life it started coming back to haunt me, and that might have been all the fucking acts, me drinking and the drugs. I left the mortuary after my 2 years. I was mopping floors at a cafeteria for the county. My dad worked for the county. And I got a phone call to join Korn. And I'm like, go back to school, be a mortician, which I was planning on doing, or I'm going to go try and be a rock star. And I chose to roll the dice and do that. Well, me and Reggie, we've had a relationship since we were kids, so it was cool to see him again. And I went out to junior high with Ted. I didn't know David or Monkey, but just seemed to hit it off. They really liked the way I sing, and it was different for them. And I had no fucking idea what I was doing. I was just being myself. I just felt like we had this, I don't know how to say it, just this magic that we did. I'm
We're done. We're going downhill from here on.
We can't do solos. You can't do no hair metal kind of stuff. No singing high and like all this stuff. Anything happy was not good. That early stuff, I was just trying to find my voice. I didn't know what I was doing was so different either. I was just young and hurting and living out my dreams.